Today I'm here in order to explain a little bit to you pharmaceutical films for solid dose medication. First of all, what are we talking about? I'm talking about blisters. Everybody has seen the push-through blisters, which are widely spread throughout India and the whole world. People most often think it's only mono PVC or polypropylene, but there's much more behind. First of all, I would explain why are blisters used in general. So a blister is a monodose package. This means every single medication is hygienically packed. You have got a mechanical protection of the medication. In case of a white film or in case of a colored film, you also got some UV barrier. Of course, one could also do it with a UV absorber in a transparent version. But bear in mind, depending on the regulations, you have to look at this is allowed or not. So as an example, in Europe, UV stabilizers in PVC for pharmaceutical medications is not allowed, whereas in the US, in Japan, India, it would be allowed. It goes on with information which you could print onto the blister. You can print this obviously onto the aluminium. You can print day packs so the people know that they need to take the medication in the morning or in the afternoon. But what I am talking about is moisture barrier and aroma, respectively gases barriers. Depending on the medication, this is required. Let's start with PVC, which is the base film for these coated and laminated films. These PVC films are all plasticizers free. Plasticizers were never used in this type of an industries. Of course, the films must comply with the regulations from FDA, from the Chinese FDA, from the Saudi FDA, the Europeans got their requirements. It really depends a little bit on the market. These mono PVCs lead to a little moisture and oxygen barrier. When you see down in this slide, the moisture barrier is specified at 38 degrees, 100 Fahrenheit, and 90% relative humidity. The most common standard is the one according to ASTM F1249. Mono PVC of 250 micrometers, which is really, I would say, 80-90% of all blisters. There you got a moisture barrier of 3, and the oxygen barrier is 13. You notice that the climatic conditions for this analysis is different, but 2350 is a global standard for this type of an application. In case this moisture oxygen barrier is not sufficient, one starts to coat PVC with PVDC. There are not many suppliers of PVDC in the market. Standard PVDC, classical PVDCs are coated in a range from 40 up to 120 grams per square meter. This is equivalent to 23.5 up to 71 micrometers. And the moisture barrier you get is dramatically better compared to the mono PVC. The 40 gram leads to a moisture barrier of 0.7 at the same conditions as I mentioned before. And at 120 grams you get up to or down to 0.2 grams per square meter. When you compare this to mono PVC with a value of 3, you see that these 23 micrometers, in the case of 40 grams, are leading already to a 4 to 5 times better moisture barrier than only mono PVC. Regarding the oxygen barrier, the PVDC is even better, meaning this factor is higher than in the case of moisture.
Sunny's Australia. He has over 3 decades of experience in the PVC industry. Among many of his achievements was the lead stabilizer replacement in Australia. He is also a member of PVC Stewardship Program and on board of Vinyl Council of Australia. Over to you, John.
forward. Okay.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for the introduction and the organizing committee for the opportunity to present this presentation today. We've seen in the portable pressure pipe application, the innovation to reduce the weight of the pipe is to from pressure PVC to MPVC and OPVC is by reducing the wall thickness of the pipe and hence a reduction in saving in raw materials. Whereas in the non-pressure pipe application, to reduce the weight of the pipe is through the foam multi-layer pipe, which I will explain in great details what we need to do in terms to produce a good quality pipe and how the stabiliser plays a key role in this process. An introduction of who we are. Sunace was established in the 1940s. We've operating 11 countries, 17 operations across the world. We have the experience and the capabilities to formulate different types of stabilisers to suit a wide range of processes and application, and also to provide the ongoing technical support to our customers. Here's the agenda of my presentation. First, we'll provide an overview of the foam multi-layer pipe, then touch base on the Indian standard, comparing the properties of the PVCU and the foam multi-layer. Also, to highlight some of the differences between the Australian and the Indian standards. In addition, we'll explain the mechanisms of the relevant additives, such as the chemical blowing agents, impact modifiers, processing aid, and the role of the stabiliser plays in terms of the thermal heat stabiliser, lubricant, and the gelation process. Also, we provide the guidance in the formulating of both the foam skin and the core, and also the processing parameters, and to provide an update on the latest trends and outlooks. As shown here, the photo of the orange multi-layer pipe, which is made up of three layers, consisting the inner and the outer wall, and in the middle is a foam core layer. The skin represents 33% and the foam core layer 67% of the pipe. The three layers provide the strength and the resistance to load when the pipe is buried underground. Both the inner and the outer wall layers are waterproof and form a protective barrier over the foam core layer, hence to be able to use a pipe to transfer water. The main advantage of the foam core pipe is almost 30% lighter than the traditional solid wall pipe. And this is a saving in both raw materials and cost. Typically, the foam core pipe is used in the application of electrical conduit, DWV, and stormwater. Here tabulated, the relevant properties and performance requirements of the foam multi-layer pipe as per the Indian standard. The main difference between the PVCU and the multi-layer foam pipe is the composition of the PVC content. The minimum PVC content for the PVC...
Very good afternoon, everyone. I really apologize, my voice isn't as good as, but I think for the next 10-20 minutes it will make it. Today evening, I have to take some more throat treatment. I would like to invite you for a journey from the product B2B sales towards the sales B2C business to customer. Because today, super interesting session on the primary process, on the raw material. But now when we have the best raw material with us, there's the main important point, these are the customers. And product needs to be accepted, technology needs to be accepted, innovation needs to be accepted, then only the great, cool ideas, what we have, what we are implementing, are going to work. I'm representing my company Lingel, and I would really like to carry on with the presentation which was there today morning with all my industry colleagues and UTMA friends. Some of them, especially Mr. Weipi Singh, we know each other since the year 2006, and 2007 was the time when first time the industry met here in Mumbai, and there we thought what to do to get a business really set up and moving ahead. When I stepped into India in 2006, many customers said, this product is never going to work in India. A factory made UPVC window, with an hardly any tolerance level was something new where the industry colleagues explored about it. Now 23 years later or 18 years later, we have seen the product works quite well, and we have to see where the market is, where the market stands, and what kind of different business proposals are followed. I would like to talk about today on value added sales. These are a few of the projects what we have done, and by the way, it's all UPVC as we are doing both the products, but this is UPVC what we see in residence on top in Bangalore with 20 feet height doors and windows, another residence here in from New Delhi with almost 4.5 meter doors on the bottom. It's a nice residence from Goa. All this is possible because when people challenge us, the UPVC industry, that the product isn't as strained, all the UPVC profiles are steel reinforced, and what we know that the moment of inertia, the strength of steel is of course much higher than the strength of aluminium. So where are we going to stand today? We learned the market is growing. We learned that we are having a bright future ahead.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. After some brilliant presentations, many technical, marketing, and specific, I would make a presentation on an industry which is called the calendaring industry. Since yesterday, ladies and gentlemen, you people have been discussing vinyl, 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 PVC, a very form, various forms, shapes, and sizes. I'm trying to make a business presentation to say that does calendaring industry make sense for the future? Many a times we keep hearing that this industry is under threat and this industry perhaps has no future. We hear for vinyl, we hear for PVC also, being part of the plastic industry, we perhaps would continue to be under attack unless, of course, we behave ourselves and do our business little differently. Not little, but quite differently. Having said that, as I know as a businessman, there is no industry in the world which is not under threat. There is no industry in the world where there is no threat of substitution. And there is no industry in the world which can continue to exist unless it evolves and develops as the mankind evolves and develops. You all know what calendaring is. It's almost like making of the Indian bread called roti or chapati, which we make it almost every day in our homes. And it has a rolling pin. It has a dough, which is essentially in our industry, it's a PVC. We make a dough out of it, add some chemicals into it, use a rolling pin, which is here, the calendaring machines, the calendaring rolls, and there it comes out, the film. It, of course, has a lot of positive characteristics, and of course, there would be nothing in the world which doesn't have negativity, so which I will explain to you.
Thank you, Session Chairman, Elite Plus, for giving this opportunity to me to speak before such an august audience. And my congratulations to Nidhi for her team, and Nidhi and her team, for an excellent, excellent conference. Okay. So my subject of interest is PVC compounds, and I will be talking about the market, of how the market is shaping up in different sectors where we operate. Before that, I'll just give you a brief overview about Bihani Group. So we've been there in the we've been there for over three decades now. We are recipient of two national awards, as mentioned. We are a star export house. We are into manufacturing and services, both sectors. We are one of the few compounding companies in the country to be an ISO 22000, which is a food compliant compound manufacturer, food grade compliant compound manufacturer. We are approved by leading global corporations, and we work very strategically with Ministry of Defense also for particular applications. And we have quite a comprehensive product portfolio. Sorry, I forgot to change the slide. So the compounding business divisions that we operate through are AEI Compounds India Private Limited, Bihani Manufacturing Company, which is the flagship for PVC products, and Seiko AEI Bihani Polymers, which is a joint venture between Seiko AEI Polymers USA and Bihani Group to produce the next generation of cable compounds. At Bihani, we have tried to be ahead of the curve by getting in products into the Indian market, which are considered to be future products, which includes electron beam curable cable compounds. We have LOCA approved compounds for in-reactor cables of nuclear reactors, LPCB approved HFFR compounds. We have recently launched UL33 compliant EV charging compound based on TPU and polyester. We have a working association with Indorama Corporation, where we do very specialized master batches, and anti-COVID is one of the it's yet to be launched in India, but it's one of the most popular ones. Then we have a separate manufacturing facility where we do PVC compounds for food and medical applications, complying to US FDA and other specifications, as I will come through my slides.
Thank you, Jaideep. Giving us good details about the compounding industry and the various applications, various standards that your company is following and trying to spread your wings across the globe. So ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of the session, but before we close the session, I would like to request if you have any questions to any of our distinguished speakers, you can ask. We will take three questions.
Mr. Bihani, Jaideep, this is Rajesh from IMP. The question is, you mentioned about CPVC in the medical field. Could you elaborate where exactly do you see that?
Mike. Yes.
I'm sorry to have skipped between my slides, but I was referring to rigid PVC when it came to medical. CPVC, obviously, no use. So probably a slide before, a slide after.
Yeah, next question, please.
Any other further questions, ladies and gentlemen?
Right. Excellent, thank sir. You. So we're thank going you. To request Rajeshji to please hand over the mementos to our speakers. They have really given us data entrenched, vision enlarged, and extremely thought-provoking presentations, and we will really like to honor them. Mr. Peter Loetscher, Head Technical Services, ACG Europe.
Yes, we request you to present the memento first to Mr. Peter, please, from ACG Europe. I will now request Mr. Rajesh to present the memento to Mr. John Chan from Sun Ace Group Australia. Yes, Mr. John Chan. Moving on, I request Mr. Rajesh to present the memento to Dr. Schmidt. Dr. Schmidt. Yes. Our next memento to Mr. Robin Banerjee from Caprihans, India. Next memento to Mr. Jayadev Bihani from Bihani Group.
I've given you.
Yes, to Mr. Jayadev Bihani. Nidhi. Yes, I'll request you to.
Rajesh, do I have the honor of giving you the memento, please?
That'll be lovely. So yes, requesting Ms. Nidhi Varma to present the memento.
He's made us go up the Great China Wall. But that's true, right? And this is my memento in honor of that, for making us walk up the snow to walk up the Great China Wall.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was our fifth business session on innovation in applications. And could we have a group photograph, please? Yes, request you all to come forward. Yeah.